We're going to work on trajectory and knowing your arm strength, hand speed, etc. So what you guys are going to do is you're going to get three balls. You're going to get a gap, a go, and a hut. Obviously, if the distance is shorter, you're not going to use everything you have, right? If the distance is farther, then you really got to load up. So what I want you guys to really focus on is to look the same, be here, and you'll be like, I'm going to set a gap. I'm going to set a go. For me, a gap is just maybe a little bit of wrist. Okay, then I'm going to extend out to a go. And then for a hut, maybe depending on where I am, I'm going to use my legs and I'm going to really crouch down and I'm going to launch that thing because it's a nice high out-of-system ball. There should be a difference in what you're doing with your arms, but all of your footwork and everything is going to stay the same. So you're going to get three perfect tosses. You're going to start off with block move. So do your block move, land, pivot, shuffle in, gap, go, hut. If you're going to jump set, you have to jump set the gap and the go. You can't just jump with the gap. If you're gonna stay on the ground, you have to stay on the ground for the gap and the go. Hut is whatever you wanna do. The gap is kind of a preference of the coaches. Some coaches run a slower gap where the hitter is still on the last two steps. Some coaches want him on their third step. Like, there's no way to plus. Sometimes your hitters are 8 feet tall and sometimes they're not 8 feet tall. And so your job is to be able to see them kind of coming as you approach. I should be able to see where she's at and get her ball. Okay, but for now, obviously, I'm not having her, and it's going to be different for everyone who is a simmer burner. You guys know that, right? So when you do your gap, we're going to shoot for like hitting it here, okay, on this side. Everyone, mental note, and then somewhere around here. On this side, okay? This is their contact point. So if that's their contact point, you're gonna want the ball to pass through that point. You're not gonna loop it in and drop it. It's not a hut, okay? So pass the point kind of like that. You see that? And then you can play with the height. It can get a little bit higher, but you want it to cross that same spot, the height.